I heard you tell this story on a Zoom that we did together with Tirico and a whole bunch of guys for our friends at Wheels Up a couple of months ago. And I'd love to, for the Super Bowl, I'd love to have you retell it about John Madden and how influential he was in helping you, you know, in a way, earn your reputation as the old riverboat, Ron. Can you walk me through that one? What a great story this is, if you don't mind.
Yes.
Hitting me on this one, Ron.
No, well, what happened was, you know, after my second season, I had this dubious record of being 3-13 of games decided by 6 points or less. And the former owner, Jerry Richardson, had told me, you know, you need a mentor. I have a friend named John Madden, who you know. He said, I've talked with him, and he's waiting to hear from you. So I called Coach, and we started talking, and he said, oh, by the way, before you come see me, you know those 13 games you lost? I said, yeah. He said, go back and look at those games and think about what you could have done differently. So I did. I went back. I looked at those 13 games. I wrote this beautiful report. Okay. It's like about 18 pages of details about what I could have done differently and how things could have changed if I had done these different things. So we set an appointment. I fly out to see a coach in his home office in Pleasanton, California. I come in, we sit down, we start talking. And I mean, it was interesting as heck. And so just as we're about to get into the nuts and bolts of our conversation, I say, hey, coach, I got that report for you. He said, oh, cool. But it's not for me. That's for you. I said, excuse me? He said, that's for you. What did you learn? Well, I said, the biggest thing I learned is I went by the book. He said, you went by the book? What book? I said, well, you know, the one, you know, I mean, you should kick it here in this situation, like, you know, in this game. And, you know, and he said, yeah, how'd it turn out? I said, well, he goes, Ron, forget this book. To go by your gut instinct. You've played enough football. You've coached enough football to go by your gut. Go by how the game feels. Do those things. And so I thought about that. Go back, and now we start the 2013 season, and we're playing Buffalo in Buffalo. And we get in the same situation. And sure enough, I went by the book. We kicked it. Go up by 6. They get the ball, drive down, score the touchdown, kick the extra point, and they beat us by 1. I was sick. I was ready to throw up on it. And everything kept flashing back to what Coach said to me. And so I'm driving home that night, Monday night. I watched the tape about 10 times, and I was just sick. As I'm driving, I'm thinking about this. I run a red light, and I almost get T-boned.
Oh.
And it just wakes me up. And I'm thinking, oh, my God. I get home, and I can't shake it. So the next week, we're playing the Giants at home. In our first series, okay, we were 0-2 at that time. In our first series, I go for it twice on fourth down. Both times we convert and score the touchdown. Yeah. And then from that point on, every time we got into a fourth down situation, thinking about down and distance and where we are on the field, we went for it. We went for it. And so as the games progressed, by about the fifth game of the season, I did it again. We played Minnesota in Minnesota on the first series. It's 4-2. We were on a shovel pass to Mike Tolbert. He scores the touchdown. So after the game, some reporter basically writes, boy, Ron Rivera, he went for it. He was gambling like a riverboat gambler. And that's how it was born, Riverboat Ron. And, you know, and it's really not necessarily about just throwing, you know, to the wind as much as it's really thinking about and calculating situations like that.
And that's how Riverboat Ron was born. That's you won on an 8-game winning streak off of that. And then obviously a couple of Coach of the Year awards after that. And now here you are, the defending NFC East champion head coach of the Washington football team. And I just to dovetail off that just a little bit is what the role of analytics plays now. You see it all the time. I mean, you went for the 2-point conversion in the win against the Giants that almost, you know, when it all came that let the Giants, you know, root heavily for Jalen Hurts against you on Sunday Night Football in game 256, you know, like, what is that push pull that you deal with sometimes?
It's about momentum and stuff like that to me. You know, it's funny because, you know, I've had coaches that I worked with, mentors like Norv Turner, and Norv and I have talked about, you know, the right time to go for it on 2. you know, like a lot of people say, well, if you're down by 14 and you score, you should go for two now, okay, and on your first score.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you do that, you just got the momentum back, and now you go for two and you miss, now you've lost the momentum. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, those are the things that Norv and I talked about. And so I've always tried to keep those types of things in mind and how you do it. So really, it's about gut feel to me. I think the analytics are there to really, I guess, just indicate whether or not, you know, this is the right time or this is a good time to do it. You know what I'm saying? Because I've had situations where when we've gone for it with the analytics and it didn't happen out, and I've been told, hey, that's okay, you did what the analytics said. And to me, I struggle with that because if I did what analytics said, and it says 9 times out of 10 you're going to complete it, there's that 1 time out of 10 you don't. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And so how do you know if you're going to be that 1 time out of 10 that isn't successful? You know what I'm saying? I mean, if there is no guarantee, you can tell me all you want. Oh, that it's 99%. Hey, that's good. Yeah, but what if you're that 1%? What if that one time it doesn't work? Nobody talks about that until it happens.
Right.
And then it's a bad decision. Uh-huh. No, it's not a bad decision. The numbers, yeah, but the numbers also said. So you just don't know. You can argue it all you want.
You could, for sure. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.